Sinclair, one.
And my name is Georgie Sinclair, two.
And I am Georgie Sinclair, three.
So I'm Georgie Sinclair, and these are the Georgie Sinclair Franchise Players. And welcome to the Big Funtime Party Show. And then we got the biggest, most funnest party show you've ever seen in your life. But first, I got a question for you. What's worse than a guy just standing on the corner with a video camera filming police brutality?
What?
A guy just standing on the corner with a video camera filming police academy. No, I'm kidding.
What's worse than getting dressed down in Navy training?
What?
Getting dressed up in Old Navy clothing. No, I'm kidding.
And what's the deal with cartoons nowadays? I mean, seriously, Ren and Stimpy, Beavis and Butthead, the Muppet Babies? These shows are terrible. My friend says to me, Georgie, that's why when I want to chuckle, I just tune in to see what's going on with the old Looney Tunes. I said, the Looney Tunes? You mean Jimmy Carter and his administration? No, I'm kidding!
Say, gang, why did the Beatles cross the road?
Why?
To run away from their barbers. Get a haircut, you damn hippies! No, I'm kidding!
Brothers and sisters. What do you expect on a birthday?
No casco kick? No? But then I have no casco kick. Okay? If I wanted a piece of cake, oh, no, 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 no. I would have to fight if I even want to get one of them little Asian flowers, you know? Like that yum, 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 yums. Okay? How are you beating them? How you all doing? How are you doing? That is fantastic. Anybody celebrating anything new? Fun? New fun? Anybody? New fan? Anybody celebrating that? Huh? Birthday? Party? Bar mitzvah? Shoes? You like the shoes? Target, I know. No, nobody's celebrating anything tonight.
It was my birthday this
week. It was your birthday this week? Okay, how old are you? 28. 28. Oh, baby. Real little baby. I was a real little baby when I met my husband. You know, they said to me, Sally, when you met your husband, André, Léon-Jean, do you feel like you were groomed? What, like I'm a dog? Woof, woof. No, no, no. Because I'm a lady! But I did marry an older man. I did do that. Okay. Anybody else? Have a fun weekend? What you doing this weekend? Eh? Ce n'est pas si confortable pour moi. That means this is not comfortable for me, okay? Ah, merde! Hey, did you see the Grammys? Grammys? Yes. You know, I do not like to swear at all, but that bitch. Taylor Swift. Don't look at me in the face. I'm practically stone cold, literally. I can barely move my body, and she did not even look at me. Look, okay, Swifties in here. I see you. I see you hiding amongst here. I can smell you. You smell like what, November? Where the fuck her songs are? With red? Oh, now you got bad blood. You also smell like a penny. Blood. That's a period joke. Ah! Ah! You did not expect that from Celine. She dirty, she filthy. Hello. I like your shirt. It's green. Bright. So bright. Blood in my eyes. No, it does not. It's beautiful. I like it. Ah, I have great vision. You know, people tell me, Celine, you sing to everything. I do not sing to everything, okay? I don't sing to everything. I just talk. I talk. But I do sing sometimes. And sometimes I bring out the big stuff, okay? Guess who went back into the ocean? Hey! Yeah. Oh, 84 years ago, I remember it so. Titanic, yes. But you know, a lot of people forget about the real meaning of that movie. There was a director. He's not very well known. Okay. You never hear people talk about him. James Cameron.
Who?
Exactly, yeah. When I heard that, I was like, who this? I don't know, but I sing for you, okay? I do one time. One time only. They took my voice. They took that song, and what happens? Oscar! Tons of Grammys! Number one! But that is me. That's singing. That's what happens, okay? But for you? For you tonight, a big party. I know we're gonna party later. Okay, we're gonna get real wild. But first, I sing something beautiful for you, okay? You're gonna cry. Every single one of you. If you don't cry, I punch you in the face today. Okay. Hey, Jack! My sweet baby. Oh. You've already started crying right now. It's gonna get real good. Okay, can you just wait? Y'all ready for this?
Yeah.
Later on, you come in with me, but first, I sing for you, okay? Every night in my dreams, I see you.
Yeah.
I feel you. That is how I know you. Come on. Spaces. swim and lift here. One true time I hope to hear my life. Well, always we'll go on. Birthday on the weekend.
Some rings totally not linked together, four of them here. All right. We're gonna link these together. Woo!
There will be no more hijinks. There will be no more weirdness. The event for tonight, I'm afraid, is canceled. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Thrix Muldoon of the FBI, and I have canceled this event due to its silliness. And I have been tasked by the President of the United States to inform you that Russian forces are advancing in Ukraine, heading west from Bakhmut as we speak. Cartel members have seized a television station in Ecuador and are holding hostages currently on live television. And I just got a text from the big man himself. Gang, in 1963, a rock group named the Kingsmen recorded the song Louie Louie. The popularity of the song and difficulty in discerning the lyrics led to some to suspect the song was obscene. The FBI was asked to investigate whether or not those involved with this song violated laws against the interstate transportation of obscene material. The limited investigation lasted from February to March 1964 and discovered no evidence of obscenity. Finally, now, on the 60th anniversary of the investigation, previously classified footage of Louie Louie and its investigation has been made public to you for the first time tonight. You are not required to enjoy it.
Come on.
Be prepared. But also cover your ears a little bit.
Some moments from my personal favorite, an actor's actor. I am an actor myself. Charlton Heston. Let us begin with the Richard Fleischer classic, 1973's Green Soylent, where he was outstretched on a stretcher, arm raised, and he uttered, "Green Soylent is people! We gotta stop them! Somehow!" Yes! 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 Thank you! Thank you! Thank you! Yes! 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 One of many! One of many! Or another great moment in William Wyler's 1958 religious epic, Ben Hur, where Charlton Heston brought his face to the ground, to utter the line, "God, help me." Or, "Indeed, yes, bravo to me." But I master thespian. Charleston Heston's body of work comes in Franklin J. Schaffner's 1968 science fiction fantasy epic Planet of the Apes! You blew it up! You maniac! Damn you! Damn you all to hell! All of you! Everyone here! Everyone at the Independent Comedy Club! Oh, God damn all those goddamn apes on this goddamn planet! I hated them! They sucked! Oh, God! Oh, what's so fucking funny, mustache? You think this is a joke? Damn you to hell! No! I'm kidding! Gentlemen, the comedic stylings of Mike Boone.
I'm just gonna do stand-up regular. Not weird. It's not gonna be weird. It's just gonna be normal. I'm just gonna do it normal. Hi. Hi. Yeah, this one's normal. Hold on. I just put chapstick on so my hands are real lubed up. I don't know, when guys put chapstick on, it's like everywhere, and then we gotta be like, ugh. I am a queer person. Hell yeah. Get out of karaoke, fuck yeah. Homos love karaoke, it's crazy. I was recently called the oldest twink in the world by a close friend. So, but I did learn the French word for twink from Celine. And do you guys want to hear it?
Yeah.
Okay, the French word for twink is Timothée Chalamet. I thought that Celine was going to say Target, but she said Target. That was crazy. That was crazy. I do like the term queer. I tried in my early 20s to call myself gay, but I realized I don't identify with joy. Not for me. Nope. Early 20s, all depression. My favorite term for myself, though, is homosexual. That's homosexual, which means I sometimes date people the same sex, and it's killing my parents. It's homicide. That one's fun. That one's fun. It's homicide. Sorry, that was a thinker. I also tried, I watch a lot of TikTok, so I tried calling myself fluid. But I hate people knowing that I'm wet, you know? That's my little secret. It's gross and it's cool. The stage is slippery from all these Doritos. I think I identify most with having no dietary restrictions. Because I'll put my mouth on anything. Hungry boy. See, it's regular. This is regular. I tell a little thing, you guys laugh, we have fun. I was in an Uber today where the lady just talked at me. And I'm a little high, so that was like cool for me, because I just got to be like her laugh track. I was just like, ah, you're right, girl, hell yeah. I was like, this fucking rocks as a high person. I was like, this is cool. Oh my gosh, I love fucking baby edibles. They're like for children. And no, I love little, because I used to always smoke weed and it would be like, my tongue's too big for my mouth and I'm in this couch now forever. And now with baby edibles, I'm like, let's go, boom, boom, boom. It's fun, it makes TV way more fun. I am an anxious person. Well, everybody else like well-adjusted? Or well, I'm Alexa bro, dude. Oh, <yeah. laughs> That's Alexa bro, that's a joke. I was one time told by HR that my anxiety is contagious and I'm ruining the whole company. Yeah, I took down a Fortune 500 company in an entry-level position. That's what I did. Actually, the next job that I had, the company did go bankrupt, so maybe it was my fault. Oops. It's a true story. I have an anxious face, where I always look like I'm in trouble. One time my friend said, no, babe, that's called resting bitch face. And I was like, I wish it was, because this bitch ain't rested a day in my goddamn life. Every dream's a fucking stress dream, dude. Fuck anybody in here ever been bullied? Yeah. Fucking get those nerds! Fuck you! Swirlies, baby. No, I was bullied a lot as a youth. I have this weird thing now when I look back. A lot of my bullies are no longer alive. Yeah, like we have like, part of it was drugs, but part of it was also like grandma and grandpa didn't make it through the pandemic. Oh, that one's disrespectful. So sorry. They just came from a different time. The greatest generation wasn't so great at giving compliments or building confidence. Anyway, but my grandma loved to threaten people with a shoe, and I think it would be hilarious to have these shoes and be like, ah. Anyway, I do appreciate bullying a little bit because I think it's the reason why my skin looks so good. I never got those hard lines from smiling. Easy breezy bully cover boy. I'm recently celebrating a year sober. Thank you! Oh my gosh! Yeah, I had a problem. like, I never did anything illegal, but there's definitely people I can't look in the eye. I was looking up activities for what to do sober, and a lot of them were just like, have you tried breathing? Like, fuck, never thought of that. What? I don't know. I did it made it a lot easier getting sober because I ended up finding crocheting TikTok. And I made 3 blankets this year, but not to brag. I just love being like the idea that I would like fall asleep in an Uber and almost throw up on the way home, and then now I'm just at home watching Clone Wars and knitting. I was really worried when I got sober that I would never have sex again. mostly because that always was a drunk activity, and it was like whoever had cigarettes at 2 a.m. was the one who went home with. Yeah, that hits hard sometimes. People are like, oh, fuck. But turns out, once or twice every 5 to 10 years, I'll still have it, whether I want to or not. That one's also weird. I gotta stop saying whether I want to or not. I don't know what that's about. I did quit drinking though because I felt like I started getting an allergic reaction. like every time I had a drink, I would want to break out into fights. That one never works as well. It's supposed to be break out into hives, but fights is one that. Yeah, don't fuck with me. You got one of the roses too, maybe. Oh, hell yeah. I didn't crochet this, but I wish I could. Anybody in here single? Yeah. Oh, God. So it's been short, so you've only been single for a couple of weeks. Jesus God. That is how it's out here in these streets. Anybody who's ever been single, you're like, yeah, fuck. Dude, never meet my mom, because being single is her least favorite thing about me. Oh my God, she loves telling me that HPV of the on the throat is on the rise. To like scare me into getting into a relationship. I don't even know what the fuck, like HPV is so beyond anything that I could comprehend in my brain. But hearing your mom say throat on the phone is very, very strange. My dear mother. That's so weird. I do, my favorite thing in the world is to read online reviews. I love them when they're good, I love them when they're bad. I can't stand a 3-star, fuck you. Like, I don't care about that. I want a 1-star or a 5-star. My favorite 1-star was for a blow mold of Santa Claus. And they sent a picture, and he was fucked. Santa Claus went to a bad neighborhood. Santa Claus was fucked. And they said 1-star, ho ho, no. Like the best thing ever. But my favorite 5-star review ever is of a male hands-free automated masturbator. 5 stars made social distancing so much easier. And then the last one is 5 stars. I just broke my second, and you know I'm buying a third. Anyway, thank you guys so much. Have a good night.
Study Shakespeare and be quite elite, and you can charm the critics and have nothing to eat. Just look on a banana peel, the world at your feet. Make them laugh, make them laugh, make them laugh.
You just gotta make it work, alright? Alright, we just, Hey, everyone. I'm Georgie Sinclair. I'm Georgie Sinclair. You drop out of community college 5 to 6 times. You're the bad seed in the family. You're the bad boy of the Sinclairs. But hey, listen. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I was at Oakland Community College. In 2013, and I was in a U.S. history class previous, before the years 1884. I dropped out, okay? The teacher was a bitch. She made me, well, listen, she had us take our cell phones and put them in a bucket. I'm not about that. I'm not about that. Can I have that harmonica again? Sorry. Hello, I'm not kidding. Apparently I'm the bad boy of the family. I'm the bad seed because, oh, I crashed my motorcycle twice. I only got a DUI once. Once. Anyways, I'm selling a sloth on the black market. He's real cute. Listen, I'll really try my best from here. Well, we got another performer coming over here. You know, this next performer is really keeping the Elvis impersonator industry alive for Gen Z. Really thought that that was a dying market, but the very talented Elvis de Vil, everybody! Elvis de Vil!
Supper. That's about all they had to eat.
you know, everyone wants to laugh. My dad said be an actor, my son, but be a comic one. They'll be standing in line for those old honky-tonk monkey shines.
Now that's entertainment. What do you say, gang?
More chicks than Georgie Sinclair. I got your ass, you little twerp. And speaking of more embarrassing than a blow-up doll, it'd be getting caught having sex with my ex-wife. Who said wife bad, you fucking Redditor? Who the fuck said that? How's it going, everybody? How's it going there, bud? Hey, what kind of hat you got on? What's it say there? Here, put it on that way. know that one's ga. Yeah. What's that one? Mega 64?
Yeah.
Fucking Redditor. Hey, put it back on. No, the other way. The other way. Keep it right there. Because you know you got something on your shirt there, bud.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got something right there. You got something right there. Look down. Fucking got your ass. On a more somber note, it's the 30-year anniversary of giving my daughter a lobotomy. I'm a silver lining kind of guy, you know. So, you know, at least it made her hotter. You know, I'm gonna say right now, that is not the reason I got divorced. It's all the fights I got into with this broad. You know, this argument we had one time, because we were at a picnic, you know, and, you know, there was a wasp flying around our picnic spot, and she wanted me to kill it, and, you know, I'm a humanitarian, so I didn't want to kill it. I wanted to leave it be. And, you know, she got upset, she wanted me to kill it, so she was scared of it, and she went over by a tree and waited, and then it flew away, and she came back, and she was, you know, miffed. And, you know, she said to me, hey, why didn't you kill that wasp? Because a wasp makes me upset. Why did you kill it? I said, I like wasps. Why does the wasp make you upset? And she said, because when there's a wasp and it comes and we're having a picnic, I got to get up and walk away. Why do you like wasps? And I said, because when there's a wasp at the picnic, you got to get up and walk away. That's fucking dumb broad. You might have heard of her. She's a comedian named Michelle Harte. The four people who know that laughed. That's fun. The other thing is she's ableist. That's the kid term kids use. Because I think I got that ADHD, you know? I forget things sometimes. Like one time I made coffee and I didn't put a filter in, and she was whining at me. She said, I did this joke out of order. I left the milk. No, I got it right. I've been cranking a couple. I didn't put a filter in the coffee. And she complained to me. She came to me and she said, you know, you gotta put a filter in. What did you do for getting this, Price? And I said, hey, you know, in my strong male ego, I said, hey, you know, maybe the reason I did it is because I like it that way. Maybe I just like my coffee pulpy. Then she has the audacity to point out that because I like it a little creamy, I left the milk out too. And she said, you left that out and now that's gone bad. And I said, well, hey, maybe I like my milk pulpy too. Got her ass. She, I think she divorced me ultimately because she's one of those lesbians. You know. And, you know, like you? Did you say like you? Up top. Yeah. But the most upsetting thing is she left me for a woman who's got a bigger dick than me. Hey. But at least I got a bigger rack. I'm almost about done here, you know. But I have been cranking a couple, and I've been having these fruity beverages. All I gotta say is, you know, there's something about a fruity tropical beverage makes me want to dance.
Jim,
where are the doors? And he said, Georgie, tonight it is all about I, the Lizard King. I said, no, stupid. I mean, where's the exit? You're terrible. No, I'm kidding. Oh, goodness, gang. Are you guys having fun? Well, gang, I gotta remind you, if you're having fun tonight at the Independent, 11 o'clock, they're having a big old open mic, and you guys are all invited. It's free. Wow. Stick around. But right now, I want everyone here to clear a path, because from, should I say Sesame Street? Because this act's gonna be sassy. Okay. Please welcome Amie Burke.
Clear path, bitch!
Woo!
banana peel. The world's at your feet. Make them laugh, make them laugh, make them laugh. Make
them laugh. Wow, that was really wonderful, wasn't it? Breathe. We've got you.
Sinclair 1.
My name is Georgie Sinclair 2.
My name is Georgie Sinclair 3.
And we're not a kidding.
Once again, everybody, that was the Big Funtime Party Show here at the Independent. And if you are inclined, the shit show, Hector Courage Comedy Open Mic, which is free, will be beginning at 11 o'clock tonight. We're going to clean this place up if you guys want to exit out. Thank you again. Drive home safely. And again, free comedy, 11 o'clock. This is George Sinclair, High Calum the Fame, the Big Funtime Party Show at the Independent Fame. Good night!